Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. A drug ring that supplied the Keene area with kilos of heroin and cocaine has been broken up, according to the U.S. Attorney's Office. Several arrests have been made, guns seized. WMUR's Ray Brewer looked at the indictments filed in U.S. District Court.
According to the indictments, the first stop for drugs here in New Hampshire was Salem. From there, the court documents say the heroin and cocaine was transported to Richmond to be distributed in Keene and the surrounding towns. The indictments say the man responsible for bringing the drugs into the Granite State is Ross Gould of Richmond. Court documents show that Gould stated that he purchased kilogram quantities of heroin, in addition to other drugs, from Lawrence, Massachusetts. A search of Gould's home turned up drugs and thousands in cash. Court documents say, in addition, approximately 14 firearms were located throughout Gould's residence. Last week at the Rockingham Mall, undercover officers began to roll up the drug ring. The indictments say that Thursday evening, the confidential informant was told to park in front of JCPenney's. Just after 8, a man later identified as Jonathan Cruz Marte allegedly got into the informant's car with a package. That bag would later be found to contain 2 kilos of heroin. But court documents show that Cruz stated he did not know what was in the bag. Also arrested was the man who allegedly drove Cruz to the mall, Felix Portes. On Friday, another bust took place at the mall involving an alleged second source for drugs. That is when Pedro Pena was arrested in the Macy's after allegedly dropping off heroin to the confidential informant.
The U.S. attorney is planning a press conference on the arrests for later this afternoon. A nearly 19-hour standoff has come to an end in Chesterfield with a man who held police at bay all that time under arrest. Police took the 73-year-old man into custody about 8:30 when he surrendered. The name of the suspect is not being released, but he will be arraigned this afternoon. The standoff began yesterday about 2 on Twin Brook Road. Police were responding to a domestic dispute. In her first one-on-one interview since the man who shot and killed her husband was granted parole, Pam Smart says she should also get mercy from the state. Smart is serving a life sentence for her role in the killing. She told WMUR's Jean Mackin that her life behind bars is worse than death.
It's a very serious sentence, and to me, honestly, I think it's worse than the death penalty. It is, because even the death penalty has an end. This sentence does not have an end.
We'll have more from Jean's one-on-one interview with Pam Smart starting tonight on News 9 at 5, including her plea to the people of New Hampshire and the governor. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, also more fraternity problems. Houses at 2 separate schools have been suspended, one for posting nude pictures of women who didn't know that they were being photographed. And another health insurer has been hacked. How many people are at risk this time? That does it for us. Thanks for joining us, and have a great afternoon.